It's not fast. It's not quiet. It's definitely not power efficient, I don't think, the way it screams constantly. But it works, and that's all I needed to do. Hey, folks, it's Thomas. I've been having a pretty stressful past couple of months. The thing I do when I get stressed is I like cleaning and organizing and moving stuff around with my hands. So I decided to reorganize my room. So in the process of reorganizing, I found this little table in my closet and I decided to make a little writing nook. I have a hard time sitting down and writing stuff and focusing. So I thought having a like dedicated place where I could write stuff down and research my stuff would make me produce more, you know, efficiency, that kind of stuff. It's hard to get video that looks nice. It looks nice in person, but I'm not good at taking video of it. And there's this sheet up on my bed frame that I use because I like being in small spaces. I feel comfortable in small spaces. So the sheet up to separate my door from my rest of my bed, it's right here. And so it's very dark in this corner, which I like. I like having a little dark workspace, but it makes it very hard to record. So I'm gonna try and make some videos of it. I'm not a good speller, so I need the computer to fix my spelling and all that. So I needed a computer. But the problem is, I cleaned up recently. I gave away a lot of my computer stuff, so I don't have any extra computer parts. The only computer I have that's put together, that's ready to go, that I don't need to build, is the one I made for my Metabots. Do not watch that video. It's not a good video. I rush that video a lot and it's really crappy, so don't watch it. But it's a very weak computer. It's basically a single core AMD CPU. I think it's an old Sephron. I think it's a 3200 plus. It's got not even a gig of RAM, 512 megabytes of RAM. It's also got an R9 380. I know that's a weird thing. I don't know why, but I put the GPU in there. I don't know why. It probably helps a little bit, but it's an R9 380X or plus or something like that. It's like the R9 380X, I think. That thing's pretty good still. PSU, you know, just bronze something. And it's in that old ass case that I really like. I don't like RGB. I don't understand why people like RGB. This case is just an old ass case. It's probably from the early 2000s. I think that's the style. I love it. It's like that off brown, like that brown whitish color, like me. It's like a lighter shade of me. I like it. It's loud as hell. It's an old Athlon, so I'm guessing it's just going to be loud for just being so old. It's not fast. It's not quiet. It's definitely not power efficient, I don't think, the way it screams constantly, but it works. And that's all I needed to do. Now, the problem is I took the hard drive out and I'm not very organized. I don't have my hard drives labeled. I just have them in a drawer and I basically just reformat them every time I need. I decided to put a new distro on. I usually use for weaker systems Puppy Linux, even though I really don't like Puppy Linux. I decided, hey, you know what I haven't used in a long time? TinyCore Linux. I don't know if I've ever used TinyCore Linux before. I have memories of, I've seen TinyCore so many times. I've seen the picture of TinyCore. I've seen it in articles. I've seen it on distrowatch.com. You know, when you're distro hopping and you're like, oh, what's the best distro for this? What's the best distro for that? And you read through articles off of Google and stuff. I have the reverse feeling of deja vu for TinyCore. Intellectually, I'm pretty sure I've used it before. I've downloaded it before. I've turned it on and I felt the complete opposite of deja vu. I Googled it actually. It's jamais vu. It threw me for a loop. I mean, I was really bad getting sleep while I was distro hopping. Like, I remember there were days, like literal days, where I would miss sleep and I would like... So I might have used TinyCore before and I literally just did not retain the memory. Like, my brain's memory banks have been corrupted. If you don't know what TinyCore is, TinyCore is developed by Robert Shingledecker. The distro started release in 2009. The goal of the distro is to create a tiny graphical desktop with a small amount of data as necessary, which they succeeded. TinyCore is only 23 megabytes of data, so the largest N64 cartridge was 64 megabytes. So that means you could put two TinyCores on and a copy of just Core, and you would still have a megabyte of data left. So that's three operating systems, plus probably like a PNG that you could put on a single cartridge. Alright, so let's talk about how TinyCore is. Woo, how is TinyCore? TinyCore is doing alright, actually. It's perfectly usable. It's not great. Honestly, it confused the hell out of me. The first day I, like, used it, I was... There was the obviously the jamais vu word of the day. But there's also, like, it threw me for a weird goddamn loop. I had a hard time figuring it out. I actually downloaded TinyCore Plus, which is just, like, it's like a bigger version. It takes a lot more data. And actually, TinyCore Plus comes... I've read that TinyCore Plus comes with Wi-Fi capabilities. I'm using a desktop that doesn't have Wi-Fi capabilities, so I can't test that. But if you're using a laptop and you want to run it off a laptop and it has like a Wi-Fi module or something, TinyCore Plus is your early option, unless you want to plug in an Ethernet cable. If you need to work it as a full distro, you can run it as a full distro. I'm not saying you can't do that. I'm just saying I personally wouldn't be able to do it. There's like little niggles here and there that you have to figure out. I was able to run Audacity on it. I didn't test it, but like the fact that it runs it, it's pretty interesting. It feels weird. It's probably because I don't spend much time actually exploring it. I literally downloaded a word processor and I'm like, okay, that's it. I'm actually removing the Ethernet off of this because it's me trying to focus. So I don't want an internet access when I'm trying to focus on stuff. TinyCore is, I feel like it's very utilitarian. It feels very old. I think it has to feel very old when it's running on such little data. But it's, yeah, it's very usable. I wrote a script on it in like half an hour. Like, I'm able to focus on the script on it very easily. Do I recommend most people use it? No. I don't recommend it for most people. If you don't need to use it, there's like hundreds of distros and Windows and Mac. Everything is way more usable. Not usable. Usable is the wrong word. The correct word I'm looking for is enjoyable. TinyCore is not enjoyable. It's very usable. It's impressive how small it is, cleanly it all runs. If you need it to do something, I'm pretty sure you can make it do it. If someone needs to run a computer, like, this isn't a bad option. It's not a preferable option, but it's not like impossible. I like it. I don't like it. I mean, it's working for me. It's keeping my brain focused on it. It's making me write more. It's weirdly interesting. It's giving me, you know, if anyone grew up around my age, you sort of remember like your teachers taking you to the computer lab when you're in elementary school and just exploring what computers are. It gives me that sort of feeling when I'm looking through it. It looks so similar to the time I grew up in that it's giving me like a whole new feeling of nostalgia for a thing that I did not grow up with. The design aspect, it's really early 2000s, I feel like. I had the graphics error where it wouldn't update the windows properly, so it would, you know, the tiling where it would tile the window over and over again. I had that error and it gave me like such a weird feeling of nostalgia. Again, TinyCore works. Use it if you have a weak PC. If you guys use TinyCore, tell me if I'm saying something stupid. Obviously, don't like, don't subscribe, don't do any of that. All right, bye. Have a good life.